Initializing monetization. Monetization process successful.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to another short episode of Live ZMU TV. And once again, I'm your host, Armand Nicholas. Today's topic is a really interesting one. I think it's pretty funny. I got this comment from, actually, it's not even a member. It was just a YouTuber that watched one of my videos and provided some feedback, and we got to chatting back and forth. And it's interesting. We talked about, you know, yeah, if I had known the things that I do know now back then, maybe I would have decided something else, right? So today's topic is 14 things. This applies to me. These are my thoughts and ideas. You know, these could be a little different for you, but nonetheless, hopefully this episode is educational. The title is 14 things to know before starting a YouTube channel. Why? Because these are 14 things that if I knew about these things back then, I might have decided to do something different, or I may have proceeded differently, or for some people, they may have decided not to be a YouTuber, right? So these are really interesting topics. So before we get started, as usual, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button already and hit the bell button to be notified of future videos. But also at the end of the video, please take the time to hit the like button and of course post some comments. I'd like to really get your feedback pertaining to this topic, what your thoughts are as far as, you know, would you have changed your mind if you were aware of these concepts, right? These topics, right? So again, today's topic is 14 things that I should have known before starting a YouTube channel. Now, number one of the most important things that I found out the hard way, right, is posting consistently. Back then, I thought that I was just gonna do a video once in a while, post it on YouTube, and of course, get some attention, get some feedback, right? And of course, blow my channel up. Not the case, okay? I can't stress this enough. You have to consistently post new content on a regular basis to stay relevant in the YouTube community, right? You have to consistently post that. So I went from posting once every 2 or 3 weeks to once every 2 weeks or a week and a half into once a week. Now I'm actually posting new videos 2 to 3 times and sometimes up to 5 times a week, just because I am just trying to stay ahead of the game. I'm just trying to stay ahead of, you know, of all of the other channels that are out there that are similar to mine, right? So I have to stay competitive. So I have to post consistently. So you have to consider this. If I had known this, that it was, you know, that I had to do that, I may have decided differently, right? Number two, you gotta gear up. Now, that's not to say that you have to get the most expensive things out there, the expensive mics, the expensive cameras, the expensive, you know, camcorders, the expensive gears that you, no, but you have to have some form of equipment. And back then, all I had was a laptop, right? And then, of course, I decided to do some videos on my phone just because the quality was, you know, fairly decent, right? But today, yeah, I have the camera, I have the camcorder, I have the tripod, I have the microphone. I mean, it's getting to be fairly expensive to maintain, right? There are ways around it. There are ways around it by getting some sponsors for some gears, getting some free gadgets from companies when you do their reviews, right? So there are ways around it, but still, it gets pretty costly, you know, in the earlier stage of what I was trying to do, right? Number three, inspiration. I mean, you've got to find a way to continually inspire yourself to do the videos. I mean, you all, including myself, have our day-to-day routine, right? Jobs, families, school, children, right? And of course, hobbies, right? And all of a sudden, you have to be inspired to find new content, find new topics, find something that your viewers are interested in. And it's hard. Sometimes it's really, really hard, and you have to do a lot of research. But you gotta push through it. You gotta push through it, get through it if you're serious enough to be a YouTuber, right? Number four, don't be afraid to use the scissor button on your editing software. What's the scissor button, right? That's the edit, that's the cut, the cut the scene part, right? Back then, yes, you all know that, you know, my videos are raw and uncut. I don't normally edit them, but I do add things to them, right? Like the little subscribe button, you know, add things to it. And there are times that I really do mess up, that I have to cut a section and, you know, and blend it to another scene, just because although it's unedited, you know, halfway through the video, I may have gotten to the point where I forgot what I was going to say, and I just, you know, blurted out all kinds of different things, and I want to take that out just because that's not really part of the video, right? So I had to learn not to be afraid of editing my video to the point where it still makes sense, it's still raw, it's still direct, it's still to the point, but it's still partially unedited, just because I don't do a lot of cuts here, cuts there, cuts here, cuts there, and re-record this, re-record that. I don't do a lot of that stuff, but still, you have to accept the fact that not all of your content is gonna be useful for your viewers, and you gotta cut them out, and don't be afraid to cut them out, right? Number five, you have, how would I put this? You just know that if you're consistently posting content and it's going out there and you're promoting it, you're marketing it, you're advertising it, you have to know that your followers will eventually come. There are going to be times where a channel's followers or subscribers may be growing slower than other channels, right? And some channels are growing faster compared to other channels. It just really depends on your content. It depends on your personality. If people don't want to watch you because you're not entertaining, they're not going to subscribe to you. You may find those subscribers here and there, but you know, it's slower than most or some, right? So you have to just know that, just put out the content out there. Eventually, those followers and subscribers will come to your channel, and maybe some of them accidentally discovered your channel, and now they're your followers, okay? Number six, okay, keep it simple. There's a saying in my profession, in the business development world or sales or marketing, right? Keep it simple, K-I-S. Sometimes we call it K-I-S-S, KISS. Keep it simple and stupid, right? Make sure that it's simple enough for your audience, your viewers, to be able to understand and follow your content. Make sure that it's entertaining. Make sure that it's easy enough to understand and easy enough to follow. Some of us, a lot of people actually have a harder time with this just because of the fact that, you know, they try to elaborate, especially when it's an educational video. You have to find a way to keep it simple, understandable, easy to the point, so that your audience will be able to follow you through your video. Okay. The next one is, this is a little bit of a suggestion to me by another member. They're asking me, hey, why don't you transcribe your video? You know, this goes without saying that opening up a new consumption channel for your content can do a lot for you, right? Unlike other parts of your video, captions do get indexed by some search engines and things like that, but transcribing your videos will actually take it to the next level, to the next platform, to the next stage of your evolution in your channel, okay? I personally have not done it. I've done enough research to it. I'm trying to find a way to do it for my video, but transcribing your video will do wonders. I have seen it happen. I've always wondered, why are they transcribing this video? And then they also have the closed caption on it. It really doesn't make any sense. But when you transcribe your video, keep in mind that you can upload this to the closed caption, to the subtitle software, and it'll automatically put subtitles on your video. So it could truly help for instance, in a different language, right? You can transcribe your video, translate it into a different language. So now you have the ability to get more audience, right? Get more audience from different parts of the world that may or may not speak your language, but can watch your video and still understand your video content, okay? The next one is big one, you guys, and we push this heavy in our team. Pay attention to video SEOs. Pay attention. Now, I'm not gonna go through all of the different SEO that we practice besides, you know, the tags, the titles, the descriptions, your thumbnails, right? and the words that you use inside your video. But the bottom line is SEO is a huge, huge part of your growth process. Again, if I had known about SEO from day one, my channel would potentially be in a different scale right now. Or if I read about all the different things that you have to do with SEO and the amount of time that it can consume, maybe I would have changed my mind. Who knows? But the bottom line is, this is something that you should know in the beginning. So if you're a new YouTuber, or if you're a fairly new YouTuber that you've been YouTubing only for, let's say, less than 12 months, these are things that you need to be aware of in order to make sure that your channel is successful, that it does what it's supposed to do for you, for your growth. Okay? Next one. You gotta develop a thick skin. What's a thick skin? You cannot be, you gotta get over the, oh, I'm too shy to be in front of a camera. You gotta get over to the, oh, I'm too meek. You know, I don't really wanna be loud in front of a camera. You gotta get over that. You gotta have a thick skin and just do your video, okay? And let the chips fall where they may. You're gonna have people that don't like your video. You're gonna have people that loves your video. The point is, the people that don't like your video, it's okay. Let them move on to other channels, right? What you gotta concentrate on is the ones that you are gaining attention from, the ones that are liking your video, the ones that are seeing benefits from your video. Those are the ones that you wanna concentrate on. So you gotta have a thick skin to be able to promote and market your video and tell people, hey, watch this video because I think you can learn something from it, or watch this video and I guarantee you, you're gonna have fun watching this video. You gotta be able to promote and push your video or your channel to different platforms or different communities, right? Now this one, I'm pretty sure you guys already know, and for me, this was a big change, okay? Get social, okay? Social media, or friends and family, or coworkers that can find your support, or in your own community, right? Local community, right? Bottom line is you have to get social. What does that mean for me? That's a big thing for me, because before I started YouTubing, I barely use my Facebook page. I don't even use the Instagram, Twitters, or TikToks and anything like that. And all of a sudden, after 2 years of doing YouTube, I find myself using my Facebook on a daily basis. I find myself trying to post things on Instagram, trying to post things on my podcasting, right? I mean, you gotta get social. You gotta get your information out in front of people, right? In your video in front of people. So, you know, it is hard for some people, especially for me, but I had to, again, develop a thick skin, right? But also, the boost of confidence. For the last year and a half, I've been gaining a lot of followers. I've been gaining a lot of subscribers, and I thank you all for believing in me, right? But at the same time, with that kind of confidence, it wasn't that hard to start promoting it, because I knew that people were wanting to watch it. So yeah, why not? I'll post it on my Facebook page and see if any of my Facebook friends would watch it or gain something from it, right? So at the end of the day, yeah, it kind of made me a little bit more social. I had to relearn all of those things. I had to learn how to use it properly. And that's a whole different topic on its own, right? Next one is the big one. The amount of time. If somebody told me that it was going to take this much time to be a YouTuber, again, I would maybe, I don't know, who knows at this point, right? Maybe I would have changed my mind, right? I didn't realize it takes so much time to be an effective YouTuber. Now, keep in mind the word effective or successful YouTuber, right? An effective or successful YouTuber is actually using your channel to do what you needed to do, to get to the next stage, monetization, to get more subscribers, to get more organic followers, right? Not just bots, or not just a community of people that basically are just not really interested in your videos and things like that. Actually getting true followers. It takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of effort to get to that point, right? But when you get there, things tend to fall in the right places. So I encourage you to just keep pushing and pushing and stay motivated, right? And that's the next one, is to continually always be motivated. You have to be motivated to do these videos. You have to be motivated to do the research. You have to have the time to do the research. And then when you do the research, you have to be motivated to find a way to present it in front of a camera, to present it to you, my viewers, on how to keep your attention going in a short period of time, right? I have to be motivated to do that. It doesn't just happen. So yes, you know, when things don't go right during the day, things didn't go right at work, is it easy to do a video? Of course not. Your mood, your mentality, your personality is not there. It's probably the worst time to do a video. But when things are going right, things are in place, it's a lot easier to do a video when you're pumped up and you're juiced up to be in front of a camera and present your information, right? Okay. And then of course, work hard to succeed. I mean, I can't stress this enough. You gotta work, work, work. Having a YouTube channel towards monetization, and of course, after monetization, is a business. And you have to work, work, work in order for your channel or your business to succeed. If you don't put in the time, if you don't put in the effort, there's a good chance that you are gonna fail. So how do some of these other ones that don't put in the time or effort into it succeed? And because some of them got lucky, they went viral. But I guarantee you, when they went viral, it pushed them, it motivated them and says, I'm gonna do another one, I'm gonna do another video, and maybe can get viral again. And they just keep going forward, staying consistent and staying motivated, right? And of course, always never give up, okay? The next thing is never, ever give up. For me, I don't know, right? I've been doing this for almost 2 years now, and it would be unwise if I give up now. I put in so much time and so much effort into this that I don't wanna give up, right? And of course, I have subscribers and followers that count on me to provide some information, count on me to guide and help them along the way, especially the new YouTubers. I love being a part of their success. I love being a part of their journey, just because it makes me feel good that I did something for them. And that's what keeps pushing me to never, ever give up, to just keep going. And at the very end of it all, last but not least, keep learning. You guys, all these videos that you see on my channel, these are not things that I just came up with, all right? This is from me doing a lot of research, doing a lot of learning, and doing a lot of collaboration with a lot of other YouTube channels as far as learning from them, gaining information from them, doing research online, you know, a lot of learning, a lot of absorption that goes on before I put out a new video. So you have to keep learning, you have to keep growing. Okay, so these are 14 things that I think personally for me, if I had known these 14 things in advance before I even opened up my YouTube channel, who knows? Maybe I would have decided not to, or maybe I would have prepared myself even more. Maybe I would have taken all 14 things, written them down, and put a plan of attack, right? Plan of succession as to how I'm gonna tackle each and every one of these subjects, so that from day one, I could have been successful right off the gate. But then again, it's a learning process, right? So once again, I'm hoping that these 14 things, maybe some of them apply to you, maybe none of them apply to you, which I doubt. I think that some of these things do apply to a lot of individuals. If all of them apply to you, hey, listen, just keep moving forward. And once again, it's never, never too late to get back on that horse. If you had a YouTube channel that you stopped using for a year or 2 years, which I've met some of these people that have had, and then found a new motivation, found a new light, that they reactivated their YouTube channel and kept going forward, it's never too late. So I encourage you to just keep pushing forward. So once again, my name is Arman Nicholas. I'm hoping that this video was of some use to you, some knowledge for you that you could learn from. And of course, I'm gonna ask, basically, take the time to like the video. Tell me what, in the comment section, tell me what you learn in the video, what you suggest for future videos. Or maybe if you have a personal experience that you basically encountered for yourself in these 14 things that I've been encountering for the last, you know, year and a half or year and three quarters, please let me know. I'd love to learn from your experience. I'd love to learn from your experience. But more importantly, the people that are reading those comments, they're learning from you as well. So be an educator, be a helping hand for other YouTubers out there. So again, my name is Arman Nicholas. I thank you for watching this video. Please hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so yet. And I'll see you next time on another short episode of Live ZMU TV, Raw and Uncut, brought to you by Team ZMU.
Initializing monetization. Monetization process successful.